Sambo.
Lennox Safari.
One thing I can tell you is that if this big boy shows up, he is toast. He is mine, and he has had his last supper. Okay. You ready?
We just got here at the camp and super excited to be here, and we're about to have some refreshing drinks and sit around the campfire and get ready for our adventure.
I really want to say thank you guys for coming over, and I really feel very blessed tonight.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Rongo Mountains in Oamaru, Namibia.
Sometimes I wonder how I ever got here.
Right here under the tree. Okay, you see the big one? Oh shit, he's big. It's over. Let him turn.
Woo, girlfriend! That's called wasting no time. You were dead solid. Good for you. Congratulations.
Oh, I'm glad I could still shoot.
No, you dropped him right in his tracks. Charlotte just shot her first animal in Africa. Her first trip to Africa, and we came to Namibia hunting with Zombo the Safaris, and she just shot a magnificent, big, wide, long, heavy impala ram. Oh, he's beautiful.
That's the big one?
Oh, yeah. It's a monster. That's a monster. Absolutely gorgeous. Gorgeous.
Absolutely. See how wide he is? And he carries that mass all the way to the top, Charlotte. And you made an absolute spectacular shot. I mean, right through the center of the neck at about 110, 115 yards.
We're setting up a second bait. This is Charlotte's impala that she shot earlier today. And we're going to set up another blind over here, away from the bait, to get the second cat that is apparently bigger than the one we saw earlier at the blind we were working at earlier today.
Unfortunately, he was not back, but still,
It's only day two, so we're still in on it.
Good.
Let's go check the other baits.
Let's go. Okay, we're checking the second bait, and there was no sign of anything coming to it last night or this morning. So we're out of luck, but we still have time.
I'll see what it is. It's cheetah. Load, cheetah one.
Thank you.
There's no holding it up?
No. It's nasty.
Good shot.
We were on our way back to camp for lunch, and the spotter spotted the cats under the tree, and we thought it would be a great kill for a first African kill. And Jopsy was explaining about how they are a nuisance animal and actually a bad problem with the wildlife that they have on the ranch, that they kill the game, and so that they have to manage them as well as other predators. So we went ahead and we took one out, and this is the only one that had his head popped up. Mama laid her head down and was smart and hid, but this one was just a little bit too curious for just a little bit too long and took care of him.
You nailed him. Well, congratulations.
Thank you.
You know, there's not everybody that can shoot a cheetah or get the opportunity on that. Yes, they are problem animals, and they're very, very successful hunters, pretty much the best hunters in Africa.
Thank you. Glad to do my part for the African ecological system.
Yes, yes.
Came up the mountains looking for kudu and mountain zebra, and it is the most spectacular view I think I've seen ever of this unbelievable country where it all began. It's an awesome experience being here, and I'm so glad I'm here. Hope we see some zebra and some kudu. Sambo! Yeah,
hunting safaris. A wonderful time here with Jopsy and Jacobus.
The leopards are eating. The humans are about to eat. Barbecue them the best ever lamb rib they're ever gonna see in their life. Some other lady called Charlotte, she shot a beautiful impala. We're having that as well for dinner. Then it's barbecue, bread, braai breaking up
the
class.
Look,
we're having a blast out here.
And this is only for Wenzel and Jopsy. The third day of our hunt. We're checking the first blind that we worked on, and still no sign. But that's kind of a good thing, because it looks like he might be showing up soon to come back for some dinner. We've just driven up on a group of impala, and there's a pretty nice ram, so we're gonna go take a better look.
so too.
Well, let's go look.
Congratulations.
That's the other shot.
Thank you.
Hell of a shot.
It's a thick, you can't see nothing.
Can't.
I don't want to boost her now, but it is a 300 yard shot.
How far?
300.
300.
We were checking the second leopard bait and came up on a group of impalas, and we saw this ram, and Yopsy said he's a good ram, so we decided we would take him. And so we tracked him a good ways over a hill and back down and back over to another, the road we came in on, and we saw him, and I didn't know really how far away they were, but Yopsy said to take the shot, so he set the sticks, and I put the crosshairs right on his shoulder, and that's where it landed, and he's well worth the 300 yards we had to walk. It was a lot of fun tracking. I enjoyed it very much and look forward to doing it again.
Cheers.
Cheers. Tomorrow,
with another
they
day.
Won't be able to do this because they're going to be in the leopard blind because the leopards are going to hit the bait tonight.
I think that damn cat is eating right now as we speak.
I bet he is.
I agree.
This is day four of our hunting trip, and we're going out to check bait and see if the day's the lucky day. And the boys have gone to some park, and we're gonna be hunting together, and hopefully I got my two little good luck charms with me. And I hope for Yopsy's sake he produces a leopard today. Thank you.
Susan, so we can clearly see that the leopard was here last night. You know, he ate half of the impala, a little bit of the zebra leg. Here is a place, exactly here where he's scratching and just marking his territory so that no other male will come in here. You have a very, very big track, so tonight is
a
night.
A very big chance.
Night must be the night.
Yes.
Okay.
So we're at the bait that the cat hit this morning. And we're getting the blind ready, and they're out there trimming some limbs around the bait. That cat should be coming back tonight. Hopefully it'll be earlier than later. There's also some little thunderstorms that are happening around us, so hopefully we won't get rain. But really looking forward to a successful hunt. I feel great. I'm not really nervous. I'm just really ready to see this cat. We've worked hard getting him here, and Yopsy's done a great job with his team, and I'm really looking forward to seeing him in a green light, putting a red dot right on him.
Can you see it? Can you see it?
Yes, I see it.
Take the shot.
Ons het nou iets geblink.
Dale.
God, dog. So where did I hit him? Right there?
That's why I couldn't come for us.
Holy shit, that's a big cat.
That is a big cat. You should have seen him, how big he was in the tree.
Look at the head on this cat.
Yeah.
Yes, sus.
There's a stucky fucking cat, dog.
He's my kitchen.
Good job, Yahtzee. I hit him.
What do you have to say for other women that have thought about hunting Africa and never hunted Africa before?
Well, they're missing out. They're missing out big time. And that's what I've been telling everybody. If you got a dream, you need to live it.
That's
you
right.
need to just and so what if you don't have the money? Give up something that you don't need to be able to do it. Mm-hmm. Oh my God, he's gorgeous.
Gorgeous.
Let's go show DJ.
Not just any old cat. At 6:30, I heard this moo, 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 right outside our tent. I swear to God, it was off in the mountain. And then we heard footsteps behind us, little hoof footprints, and I looked over him and I said, what's that?
Zebra. That's kind of a woman, she can't keep quiet.
Know that feeling. Welcome to the club.
He turned the light on, and you could see this much of the cat in the light.
Wow. And he was so big, he took up more than the light.
Yeah, and he was standing, he was going up the tree. It was like this. It was beautiful, perfect, classic leopard pose, crawling up the tree. And I shot him right there, and it just came out right here. And then we heard it hit. I mean, it went boom. Exactly. Then when the guys got here, it got real Western.
You see,
everybody's walking around carrying guns, like the TV shows, going around the corners with the lights and all this stuff. And yeah, it's
I stayed with Susan in the truck. We had Jacobus
and Wenzel and Yahtzee, and David's with them. And I'm just like, oh God, just don't let them get David.
Oh. Just want to say congratulations for you. Animal, Yahtzee, for a great job.
Great job.
And guys,
yes.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Team effort.
Good night.
Susan, DSC is truly where these types of adventures and friendships all began. Mm-hmm. And for you, it was DSC South Texas, the new chapter of DSC in San Antonio, Texas, where I introduced you to Yahtzee and Dzambo Safaris. So we're here and you accomplished something that many, many safari hunters absolutely dream of accomplishing.
Well, it was definitely a lot of work getting the cat to come in to the bait and tracking its movements and the timing of it, but I'm really glad that I was able to meet Yopsy. My husband and I went to the Dallas Safari Club South Texas chapter meeting in San Antonio in January, and little did I know that a short 90 days later I'd be here, and not only here in Africa, but with a spectacular trophy leopard. I'm just amazed. Yopsy knew what I wanted, and he made it happen. And I really just, the words can't describe the, and I haven't even felt it yet. It's just unbelievable what it feels like to not just see one of these animals alive, but to also be able to take it home with me, to forever be memories of this great trip. And I'm just really glad that we went to that Dallas Safari Club South Texas chapter meeting, the gala.
That's right.
And
first annual.
We were celebrating, and we'll continue to celebrate. And I just think that if it's important to you, if it's something that you really dream, don't think it's impossible, because it can happen. It can happen. It's reachable. It's attainable. And thanks to the Dallas Safari Club for all of their support for this industry. It is an industry in Africa, and I had no idea the impact that it makes, but truly is the lifeblood of this continent.
Well, Susan, from the Zomba Hunting Safaris, I just want to thank you for coming over and just make a difference. And Blake, you and Larry Wisen, always been dear friends to me. And you know, of all these trophies in, I would say, the world, all of the big five, this is pretty much the most toughest one to get. And just to add on, this is a damn big leopard. So I just want to congratulate you.
Well, thank you. Congratulations to you.
Good shooting. And
it was team effort.
Definitely it was.
Congratulations, Yopsy. And to you, Miss Susan.
Thank you. Thank
Jealous.
You.
Yes. Unbelievable. Beautiful cat.
And not only has it been, the hunt has been fun, but the time together here has been great. You guys have done a wonderful job being our hosts and making sure that every need has been met and every beyond the expectations. It's more than just the hunt. It truly is.
The camaraderie.
And, you know, the animals that you grew up reading about and seeing in the zoos, and you come out here and you see them in their natural habitat. There's no words to describe. It just takes you deep in your soul, and you find a new love and appreciation for these animals. And when I saw him in the light yesterday, the sunlight, it was just the sky behind him, and I was speechless. And then after we took him and went over and saw him, and oh my gosh, he was just a magnificent animal, and I wasn't even able to express my emotions because I was in such awe. And it was a great hunt from day one, and it took us 4 days. 4 days of baiting and tracking and timing and praying and hunting, and it was a great, great expedition.
You're welcome.
Well,
let's get this guy into the skinning shed.
Get him skinned out. He's gonna make a beautiful mount.
Yes.
Thank you to DSC and Zombo and my sponsors.
And they are
the good Lord above.
Amen.
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 David.
the ride.
Oh my God!
This is incredible.
Gorgeous!
Drive.
Yeah. It'll do.
It'll do.
But this hunting camp in
this
particular,
one, right this here, one,
is
right
here
where we
special.
Are,
it's pretty special.
Tell you something, Zombo Hunting Safaris Namibia has the inside info on where the big boys are. Now, if you want to go kill a big one, you know who to call. If you just want to go kill a cat, call who you want.
That's right. That's right.
We know who to call. We know who we're going to be calling.
Mm-hmm. Every year.
That's
we're
right.
We're coming back.
That's right.
That's we're coming
every
back.
Year.
We're owning stock in Zombo.
Yeah,
Safaris.
We're going to be investors, silent partners.
Partners.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. That's right. That's us.
And this lady right here who just started her quest for the Danger 7.
Yeah, got the number one.
Shot the number one Majestic of the Danger
7. Didn't start
7.
On the bottom of the totem pole.
So we are moving on now soon to buffalo and elephant and hippo and croc.
Mm-hmm.
And you just wait. You're mm-hmm. going to know who this person is.
Yeah, they're going to be asking you.
That's right.
Who
you.
Is that person that, you that see, you're so proud
you,
of?
You.
Hey, they did not just like that.
It's the first morning at the new lodge, and we are loading up and getting ready to go to the gun range and check our rifles and make sure they're still on sight and shoot some targets that are a little further away, like 400 yards instead of 100 yards. And then we are going to load up and go see some animals. Really excited because last night when we were coming in, the first animal we saw was a white rhino, and that kind of got our blood pumping. And we're pretty stoked about this place. It's gorgeous. The accommodations are 5-star, and so far we're batting 1,000, so we're excited.
Okay, Susan, we're here at the new camp down south, basically the Namib Desert, the oldest desert in the world. We're here for a nice plains game hunt. As you can see, there's rhinos, gemsbuck, springbuck, black wallabies, everything around us. You know, so I think we're in for a hell of a time.
Yes, we are. I can tell already.
Get into the car before this bad boy.
Yeah, yeah, let's do. Just checked our rifles and everything is a go. Yopsy's working on DJ's gun, which is off just a tad, and looks like it's fixed, and we are ready to go. Good hunting! Ready to go find some beautiful animals.
Good shooting, man.
Thank you.
Well done. You make me proud every day.
Thank you.
You make me proud.
All
Well, Susan, this morning we drove into these zebras. This is called the Hartmann zebra, also known from the Namibians as the mountain zebra. This zebra is indigenous to Namibia, so that means you only find this zebra in Namibia, and that is why it's so cool. Yes, you get a whole lot different kind of zebra. You get the Burchell zebra and East Africa zebras. But why this zebra is so special, you know, it is way bigger than all the other zebras. It has bigger ears, it has a wide belly, its stripes go down to the hooves. So this zebra is just majestic. Beautiful. I want to congratulate you on this excellent, epic Hartmann zebra.
Thank you. Thank you. It was very exciting when we saw them up on the ridge, and we trailed them for a little while, and then he gave us the perfect opportunity. He had a friend with him, and they were scouting around, I guess, and it was just unbelievable seeing him standing there and gave us quite a— I've never seen anything so tough. I mean, this is my first major African kill that's a bigger animal, and I'm dumbfounded by how unbelievably strong they are. He didn't want to go down, and unfortunately we had to put two more rounds in him, and one of them didn't even exit. We had to actually shoot him in the neck, the last one, and the slug didn't even go through. It went in and it stayed. It didn't— I mean, I'm just shocked. They say everything's bigger and tougher in Africa, and by God, they are. I guess that's how they've survived. I know that's how they've survived all through the eons and ages, and our prehistoric animals that are still among us. And I'm in awe, and he's a good old guy. He's seen his better days, and I think he's definitely the old guy, and we made room for one of the new guys to come in and bring in some new blood to the herd, and I'm really proud of this. I never thought I could shoot a zebra because I love horses so much, but they're so different, and it's seriously a trophy, and I can't wait to have him at home and admire him for the rest of my days and the memories.
Well, so. Susan, congratulations.
Thank you.
Beautiful shooting. Let's get this bad boy on the truck.
Yeah, that's going to be fun. That's going to be fun.
Okay. Him on the shoulder. Kunk. Leave him, leave him, he will die. Shoot him again on the shoulder.
While he's moving?
Yeah.
Maybe I'll wait.
Wait a bit, let me see. Okay, just shoot him again. Let's aim a bit higher on the shoulder, you know?
That's— sorry, big fella.
Of adrenaline again.
Good job. Look at them, nice old bull.
He looks prehistoric.
You see, this is when they get big, when the skull goes below the eyes. So that's what I always try to look at.
Uh huh.
Heavy horns, everything. Good job.
Thank you. Well, this was exciting. You brought me right to the guy you had planned for me. Thank you for that. He's beautiful.
No, you're very, very welcome. You know, I just saw yesterday this very, very big black wildebeest bull, you know, with this massive curls and bosses and just nice tips on him. And I just, you know, thought, you know, we can come back for them because they're so territorial. So, you know, I'm very happy that you made a perfect shot. Just to give you a little bit of background about these black wildebeest, you know, they were in the 1940s, 50s, 60s nearly extinct. So there was about 50, 60 of them left in the Free State in South Africa. And just one farmer decided, you know, keep them and breed with them. And today they strive in a lot of numbers again.
Yep.
Also known by the black people, this black wildebeest, as the clown of Africa. Because you will drive around them and you just see their running circles going crazy and stuff. So we know these black wildebeest are the clown of Africa.
Right.
What is very, very nice of them is that they have a nice white tail on them. A very nice, you know, this beard in front of the nose. So they're very unique, this animal. And you shot a truly, truly beautiful animal.
Yes, I did. I'm very pleased with him. When we pulled up to take a good look at him, he acted like he was wanting to come over to us.
Yeah.
He was checking us out. I don't know if he didn't like the fact that we were moving in on his territory or
exactly that, exactly.
He surprised me. He surprised me. He made himself available.
Well, Miss Susan, good shooting.
Thank you.
Let's get this guy to the skinning shed.
Let's get him
well
there.
Well done.
Thank you.
Gunk.
Thank you.
It's the height issue. That's what it is.
Yeah.
Well,
thank
done.
You.
Good job, buddy. Good job.
My first African animal. Well, we were on our way in for lunch, and we spotted a group of about 5 springbuck. And Yopsy decided that we were going to give it a try, and he's been very patient, and he got us on them, and we made a good kill shot, and here we are.
If you know, the springbuck is a proud, proud Namibian animal, and it's a very, very fast animal. The cool thing about the springbuck, it has this prong here. You guys saw, you know, when it died or when it's jumping,
right?
It just shows this white prong, and you know, it's all about exuberance. Then they do that when they're playing or bragging, then they just show this prong. What a lot of people doesn't know is if you put your nose here and smell this prong, it smells like candy.
Oh yeah.
Try it.
Wow.
So yeah, that's the cool thing about it.
That's neat.
Yeah.
They're musk.
Very nice.
Congratulations again on a wonderful animal.
Thank you, Yopsy.
Beautiful. Beautiful.
Okay.
Wonderful.
Now the other thing that you don't know, in Africa we have a tradition, especially in Namibia. I didn't want to do it with you. I was waiting for DJ as well. If you shoot your first African animal, you have to eat the liver and get a bit of blood. That's how I grew up. That's how John grew up. David, everybody. You're in my country. When you're in Namibia, you do what the Namibians do. So I'm just going to give you each a piece of liver, mess your face up a bit with blood, then you're true African hunter. Let's start with that knife, please.
He thinks he's going to make me eat this lamb liver.
Don't think so, I know so.
Here we go.
You don't do this to anybody else.
Yeah, I do.
No, you don't.
I don't have any glasses.
No! Oh.
Come on, woman.
Just do a little.
You shot a big leopard. Come on.
Yeah, be part of it.
Be part of your husband. Okay, welcome to Africa, swallow that thing.
Swallow.
And you've been blessed by the African hunting boys.
We came out this evening of day three, I think, and we came up on the springbuck, and I need a kill for my leopard for the mount, and so we saw this one, and we thought this would be a good one to put in the tree, with the leopard carrying it up the tree the way we saw it climbing in the tree to get the bait when I shot it. It's a pretty good little springbuck. Yopsy always performs according to his profession of how perfect and awesome he is.
Okay, DJ, there's some blue wallabies, but that bull is really big. What I need from you is a perfect shoulder shot.
Okay.
But remember, after you shoot, reload quickly and shoot, if you can, if he's in the open, shoot two more shots into his body.
Okay.
As they're extremely, extremely tough.
Okay.
The second shot in your mountain. He's gonna come fast to the right.
Another shot, come.
Good job, buddy.
All right.
Holy.
All right.
He's down for all money.
Thank you, Yapo.
Good job.
Woo!
Look here, just feel here. Feel all the blood and the thickness here.
From where I hit him?
Yeah.
Just beautiful, the color.
Yeah, it's just patience. We saw a lot of them. It's just patience.
DJ, this whole day we're looking for blue wallabies. We did saw a lot. We came up and we saw this one in the herd. He was really the breeding bull, the main bull. You can see he have a lot of fight marks. He's white, he has a nice curl. Good tufts on him. You can take it from there. I think it was a wonderful shot.
I'm very, very pleased. These are amazingly tough animals. The first shot, you could tell he was really hurt. Yopsy instructed me to immediately reload and put another one in him. It took just a little bit of tracking, and here we are with this wonderful wildebeest. I thank you so much, Yopsy.
Well done with your poor man's buffalo.
There you go.
We spotted five blue wildebeest bulls earlier this morning. We saw there was an extremely, extremely big one. I think let's just put a stalk on them, try and shoot one of that big one. As I said earlier to DJ, you know, these are the poor man buffalo. They're very, very tough. So if you have a second and a third shot on the same one, just take it. Reload okay. Quickly. Make sure you squeeze off your first shot perfectly on the shoulder, and then let's take it from there.
Okay. In the back?
No, second from the back. Okay, just check. He's now third. Third.
On the left?
Yeah, on the left, third. He's now.
Whoa! Yeah! Wow! Yeah!
That's how you're supposed to shoot.
Wow! Hell of a shot.
I love this. I aimed at his nose.
You aimed at his nose?
Yeah.
Perfect.
And it was very, I have to congratulate you on this one.
That was fun.
That sure as hell was fun. Now I can see.
We're going to have double gins tonight.
Yes, we are.
My American sniper. That's how you do it. From now on, that's how you shoot.
That's how I shoot.
Susan, I'm absolutely speechless. I don't know what to say. The first time that I see that a Texan woman do, I want to say shit like this. This was wonderful, you know?
It was very exhilarating running through the desert like a John Wayne movie, Hatari! And you told me where to aim. I don't know, how fast were we going?
Maybe 110 miles per hour.
Yeah, I think so. I put the shot right where you told me, right at his nose, and put the brakes on.
Yeah,
pretty lucky shot. That's luck.
No, you aim for that, so I won't say it's luck. And you spined him nicely. It dropped like a bag of potatoes.
It's a yell of a big bull though. So I want to say congratulations, woman.
Thank you, honey.
You did well.
Thank you. It was fun. It was fun. A lot of fun. We stalked him for quite a ways. Fired 2 shots, complete miss, and got in the truck and didn't give up. And man, it was a rodeo out here. It was a blast. DJ was in the back with me and Yopsy, and was in between us, and Pam and John were in the front, and then we had David and Titus behind us, and I was afraid we were going to lose Titus and David, and they held on, and it was certainly worth it. Certainly worth it. He's a beautiful animal. He's the poor man's buffalo, the poor woman's buffalo. So,
well, let's get him into the skinning shit.
Let's get him in.
Susan, we just spotted the nice big kudu bull. He's hiding in those trees. So what we're gonna try, we're gonna try and move around, get some height on in our advantage. Try and get onto that small little hill. It's gonna be a quick shot, you know. Once we see him, put down the sticks, get on him immediately and take him.
Okay.
Just get ready, put your rifle over here. I think he's hiding in here. I don't see him.
He's good over.
Must be just somewhere there. Comes, here he comes, here he comes. Take him, take him. Again, again.
Fuck.
Take your time. I say, you woman. Woo-hoo. This woman is my woman. My American sniper. And that's a big cooter bull, let me tell you that. Woo! Awesomeness! Look at him! Look at him!
Oh, wow, yeah.
You can be very proud of this kudu bull. Look how big is his body. Hell of a kudu bull.
The kudu is known as the gray ghost. They just hide and they're gone. They don't run when you pull up because they think you can't see them, and they stay in the bush. And then once they see that you see them, that's when they run. But you don't even see them. They just disappear. It's unbelievable how God created them to be so adapted to their environment, and or the environment was created for them, or they're created for the environment, but it's just so perfectly matched. And he was explaining to us earlier also about the curls and how the kudu bulls fight. And when they fight, you think they can't see. And how do they fight each other? Because they can't see, because they have to put their horns down. But he showed us how if you look through the spirals, you can see perfectly through and see their eye, and they look out that spiral. So just every little detail is so fine-tuned and taken care of for these animals. It just amazes me. What makes a trophy is not just pulling the trigger and hanging it on your wall and having people admire it. A lot of it's the actual hunt. And the stalk. We had a mountainous climb. We came up through several mountains and pretty hairy drop-offs, and had to get out and walk at one point because it was so steep and so loose. It was dangerous for us to be in the vehicle, and John had to maneuver it by
help with getting help going up, being able to see where he could put the tires, and that was cool. And then we came through and we saw some zebra and some different things, and then we came up on a windmill and found out that it hadn't been working and there was no water, so we were worried that there was no animals in the area because there was no water. Go around a bend and we're driving down the road, and we're up on top of a mountain, and see these ears sticking out from the tree trunks, and turns out it was this old boy, and he found water somewhere because he had some water in his mouth. But it was pretty cool. He went and hid in the trees, and then we, Ropsy and David and I, got out and stalked him and went up on top of this rise over here and looked for him and had a good feeling of where he was down below us in the trees. He was still in the same little clump. And so he got Titus to go out and drive him out. And when he ran out, I was on sticks and I took a shot and I didn't hit him with the sticks. And so I just turned and took a running shot and did what I was told, aim at the nose, and kind of did a quarter turn and got a good vital shot, and he dropped immediately. I'm happy to do my part in keeping the herd happy and healthy and genetically strong. And it was a great, great, exciting hunt. And I'll never forget it, especially when I walked up and saw just how big he is, because I had no idea how huge they really are. So anyway, oh, and I want to thank my sponsor, God, because he's the only one that could have brought all these animals to us. It's just been a spectacular trip. It's not over yet, but sure has been remarkable.
Grand Slam now. We actually did yesterday finish that beautiful springbok. We're behind the black springbok now.
This guy was really hard. What a trip. We tracked him for probably a couple of miles, and he was not easy, but that's what makes it a fair chase. They're so smart. Their hearing and their sight is so keen and sharp that I don't know how predators ever catch them, but we finally came up a creek and creek bed, and then we crossed over, and he was about 140 yards, and I missed my first shot, and my second shot I got him in the leg, slowed him down, and he laid here for a little while, and then put another one, the kill shot, and I wish I didn't have to do that, but anyway, and he's a good ram. DJ and Charlotte and John are in the truck, and David and Yopsy and I have been trailing him for probably about an hour. And they're coming to get us now to get him loaded up and take him in to get it skinned. So I'm really proud of this one. This one was some sport.
Susan, Tuesday morning, about 7:30. We're behind the white springbuck. Let's just hope, you know, we don't have to struggle 2 hours like we did yesterday in the black. But there's some big ones that we just spotted. We're gonna use this river, this cover, to get close to them.
Well, day three of the Grand Slam, which is 4 springbok. The white one is definitely a prize, and gave us quite a fun time finding him and locating him and taking him. He was the bull of the herd and was very busy with his women, and he got a little bit stupid and gave us too much time to take him. So I'm very proud of him, and I thank my whole team for everything that they do to help me take these animals that I've always dreamed of having and never even knew of. And I'm sure proud of him, and look forward to displaying him for people to enjoy for a long time.
Got him.
Easy. He's gone.
Good job, sister.
He's gone, his dad. Safety on.
He's moving. I got to go out hunting with Susan and Yopsy this morning, and we came upon this zebra up in that mountain. And I don't know how far we were, about 200 yards from it, I guess. And took a shoulder shot. And then came over and got him over here. It's absolutely amazing the emotion that you feel when you see these beautiful animals. Absolutely amazing. When I got him in my crosshairs, I had to keep telling myself, it's a white tail, so that I would stay calm and just shoot like I'm used to shooting. Because it's so majestic. And to be able to be here, is amazing.
Got him. Good job, sister.
Thank you.
right. Well, we had just got through picking up Charlotte's zebra that she had shot, and Yahtzee had spotted some Gims buck before we had come through there. So after we got her zebra loaded up, we all took a hike up over the mountain. And sure enough, the Gims buck were coming up over the mountain just across from us. There was probably close to, 60, 80 Gims buck moving. We thought they might stop. They never would stop. Getting towards the middle of the herd, Yahtzee said, take the shot running. We took the shot, knocked them down. They're very tough animals. We made the hike down here, made the kill shot, and here we are. It was a great hunt.
We're on the fourth stage of the Grand Slam, the fourth animal, which is the Copper Springbok. We're waiting to see if they'll come back by this way so we don't have to stalk them, hopefully, because it's so exhausting. But anyway, we're waiting for them to come back by, and we hope we get them.
Perfect shot, leave him alone. A bit low, but it's fine.
We watched him for a little while, and I took a shot. I hit him the first time. Unfortunately, I wounded him, and we tracked him, and we took him as fast as we could. He's a beautiful, beautiful ram. Came off the out of the mountain, and I'm just really proud of this one. He's beautiful. I just love these little things. This is the bronc. And it only does this in certain times, and it happens at the moment of death. And it has a real sweet smell on the inside. Some people say it smells like candy, cotton candy, different things. I think it smells like a sugar cookie almost. It's kind of got a little brown sugar taste. I mean, smell with a little butter. It's just beautiful, and I'm really proud to own him. He's beautiful, and he'll be respected and admired for a long time.
Okay, Susan, I just want to congratulate you. This is the Copper Springbok, the last of the four that you killed. You know, you got the Namibian and Southern Grand Slam, which is a very big prestige. There's not a lot of hunters that really, you know, shot the Grand Slam. Even some of them in camp, like Blake and them, been here a lot of times to Africa, but you're a hell of a shot.
Well, thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much. I'm so glad I did it with you.
Me too.
I'm so glad that we're here, and I'm so glad that Blake introduced us, because it's going to be a long and fun friendship, because I'm not coming back to go hunt with anybody else. You definitely inspired me and showed me parts of myself that I hadn't seen in a long time.
You saw that golden oryx,
mm-hmm.
golden Gims buck. We spotted that one right now. Unfortunately, she's a bit injured, and so that gave Susan the opportunity to have a shot at her, you know, because to get a vet out here in the desert is not going to work. And we really want that animal out of its misery. And, you know, at least you can take it back home to Texas. And
we can do our part
in conservation,
being offering mercy.
Okay, let's go try and find her. Just need her to turn sideways. She's very big. Let's just stay in one line that they can see.
Hold her.
Yeah. She's very big. Well done, Miss Susan.
Thank you. She's beautiful.
She's very big. Susan, you just killed a golden Gims buck. You know, these animals are one of the prettiest animals pretty much in Southern Africa. They're actually
only occur here in the desert areas where we now, the whole south of Namibia. That's where they really came from, you know, and just these mountains, this sun, and just a lot of breeding, and you know, all of a sudden there was a lot of gold and gemsbok between the common ones. And you know, the local ranchers and the game breeders, they just later on capture them and start breeding with them, and they became very popular. And today, you know, they just thrive. There's so many, there's more than 1,000 of them already. So, you know, it's a very cool animal.
They're beautiful.
See all the gold in him, no black, nice golden tail. Even his horns are a bit wider, you know. It's a majestic animal.
It was very hard to spot against the rock and the sun. It was really neat. Quite a trek we made. She gave us a lot of trouble. We stalked her, we found her. She gave us a shot, got ready, started walking. Had to wait for another shot. She walked through the brush. We had animals that were getting in the way. Sable bulls, curious, wanting to know what was going on. We had to wait for them to get out of the way. And then finally, she came out and she gave us a shot. And I'm glad it was a quick kill for this old girl. She deserved it. And I'm really proud of her. She's beautiful. And she's gonna make quite a nice addition to our collection of animals from Namibia. I'm very proud of her.
So Susan, congratulations on this wonderful.
Congratulations to you too.
Oh, give Papa a hug.
Isn't this your first golden gemsbok?
Yes, ma'am.
I'm honored.
You should be.
I'm honored.
Well, let's take some beautiful pictures
thank
of this animal.
Thank you for sharing this experience with me, making the opportunity available.
Yeah, you're welcome.
What?
Give me the camera.
You want me to shoot it?
Yep.
You need ears? There it is.
What are you running back at you?
Great shot, Cody.
Great job, Cody.
Absolutely.
Appreciate it.
Congratulations, Brini.
Oh,
thanks, sir.
Yes, for sure. Yeah. So, for your first trophy, Springbok, in Namibia, we dub you Sir Miss first, and then shoot it, right? A little of this beard, we need to get of this beard, color it in.
Okay, so it's a lovely day out here, and we brought Cody out for a good springbok hunt. He managed to take it down.
Ready for this?
Mm-mm. No.
Yeah, go. Chuck it in.
Brendan!
Talk to me, Brendan!
Give me just a minute of your time today.
Susan, we here at the new place. We just spotted a yellowfoot water buck bull. Let's try and make a small stop and see if we can just get him.
He's really pretty.
I need you to make sure on that nice shoulder shot.
Okay.
Spotted a zebra for you. That's a lonely male, so let's see if we can get to him. Unfortunately, there's so many game that we have to beat, so let's just hope they give us a chance.
Okay.
There's no way we actually can beat them. Let's just hope they run to the right directions. We're just gonna go straight for that zebra.
Straight at him?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, boom. The zebras are just out of reach. If you're willing, let's try and shoot a base buck. Because we're running out of time. Gotcha. Okay, good shooting.
Thank you.
He must go down. He doesn't have an option. Running out of oxygen. Good shooting.
Thank you. Very nice. Thank you very much.
Yeah. Nice testicles.
Thank you.
Well.
Thank you.
You've got some.
Thank you.
Supporters for tonight, yes?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Perfect.
Oh, it's a female. Wrong one. Female.
Yeah, right.
Well, we started out this stalking a herd of zebra, looking for a zebra stallion, and we quickly began losing light and worked our way up to a tree that had put us probably within range of the zebra, but it was just too hard to identify the stallion with losing the light. When Yopsy looked over and saw this blessed buck bull at about 220 yards and said to go ahead and take it, and so we took it, and I'm very happy with him.
We just spotted now a big, big black red RBs, a lot of bulls. Let's quickly try and see if we can't find them.
Really good. Good looking.
Okay, let's go check.
I'm excited.
Just wait there, it turns. That one broadside.
Okay.
That body is nice. Yeah, you're injured. Good shooting.
He's down.
Good job, woman.
Thank
That's
you.
That's a big one. You saw it.
I did.
You saw it yourself.
I did.
Okay, I'll put that.
Yes. Well, this is exciting. This is the third one of my beast collection. It's the triple of the triple, and I'm really proud of it. It was a lot of fun. We rode up on him and saw him in a group and picked him out right away and watched him, and as they started walking away, we knew we had to get the shot, and Yopsy got those sticks up and took me a minute to compose myself and just took the shot, the best one I could get, and it ended up being the right one, and boy, am I proud of this one. These guys, they grow some beautiful animals here, and I'm excited about this. It was a lot of fun. Fun tracking him and trying to find him. And I mean, it was the full meal deal with this guy. So I'm really pleased, and I'm proud to have him. And thanks to everybody who played a part in this wonderful trip.
DJ, this is basically the last day of our 14-day safari. You know, we ended up with a spectacular kudu. You know, as you know, Yapsi always leaves the best for last. So, you know, tell us what you think. You know, tell us what went through your mind.
Like Yapsi said, it's the last morning of the last day, and we've seen several young kudu bulls throughout the morning and whatnot, but nothing that was a shooter. And we came across this old boy. He was a little dumb in love, paying attention to some cows and not to us. And thank God it was my lucky day, because we've got him on the last day, and I couldn't be happier. Thank you so much, Yapsi.
Congratulations, DJ.
Thank you very much.
Let's get this bad boy into the salt.
Let's do it.
Okay. Oh, just as you walk, you shot. Reload, reload, reload. Okay, good job.
I don't even know where he is.
As long as your pH knows.
Hey.
That's a hell of a shot again.
This was a lot of fun. This was the last evening of our last official hunting day. And we stalked this beast, and he was a long ways away, and I wasn't quite sure. I didn't think he was a bull. I thought he was a cow. He's not very well endowed, but anyway, we turned out to be a bull.
Well, Susan, congratulations on your wonderful.
I'm glad you saw the nuts, because I didn't see them.
Well, I'm the peer, so I'm supposed to see them.
Yeah.
You know, I think we just had a splendid time, and the whole trip was just magnificent. Different scenery. Now we kind of here, central Namibia.
Yeah.
Pretty much the home of the camel thorns, and
I'll take one back with me as a souvenir.
So no, thank you for everything, and you know, I'll see you in the near future.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to coming back. Okay. And looking forward to you coming over.
That's
seeing us. But I'm real proud of this guy. He's real pretty. I'm gonna be display him proudly and enjoy him for a long time. So I just want you to know from the bottom of my heart how much I appreciate all of the fun that you've allowed us to have hunting with you and showing you the world.
You're very welcome.
Okay guys, I just want to say it was a great hunt, great everything. Congratulations on all your kudus that you shot this week. And yeah, enjoy.
Every day was my favorite day. Every day. I woke up to the sights and the sounds and the smells of Africa. And every day is my favorite day. From the day I got here until the day I leave, it's my favorite day. My favorite thing. I love the hunting. I love the adrenaline. I love the high five. It's exhilarating. Every day has been my favorite thing. Every day. There's nothing that I can say was better than something else, because each thing was so rewarding. Everything that we did, we moved from one camp to another, and each one opened up new possibilities and gave us new experiences. We met new people and got to know some of the wonderful, beautiful people of Namibia, and feel very fortunate to have met them and become friends with them, and look forward to seeing them again, and hopefully, hopefully hosting them to come back to the United States and Texas to see us and let us show them a little bit of our world. But there's not one thing that I can say is my favorite thing. It's all been great. Every single moment of every single day. The travel was beautiful. The accommodations have been astounding. The hospitality, the culture, the friendliness, the beauty of the environment, the geography of Africa, the animals, it's all my favorite thing. And I'm going to take a little bit of it back with me, and I will never be the same. I'll never be the same. Never be the same.